On this inverter troubleshoot, we have an issue on the AC side of the system. Let's start from the beginning. The call was, it comes in, the homeowner, hey, my system's not working. I think the inverter's down. Right. They're correct. So when you first get there, visual inspection, just walking up, what do you see? What do you notice? Now on this site, you see here, this display screen, it's off. There's nothing on there. The DC disconnect switch on, toggle switch on, this AC disconnect was also on. So you should see lights on that display screen. On the solar edge inverters, what normally happens, even if there is an issue with that inverter, it'll throw an error code and you'll be able to see that error code on the display screen. Super smart. They're basically like little computers. When you're not able to get any display on the screen, it means that there's generally not AC voltage flowing to that inverter at all. So right then and there, that's my first impression. Why is the screen not on? Is there not voltage? The first thing that you would do here after turning everything off, open all the circuits, kill that, and pull this lever down, you can safely access the inverter, right? So you take the screws off and you want to check the AC voltage on the AC terminals in the inverter. Right? You check line one to line two, you should see 240 volts in that vicinity. And you should also see 120 from line one to neutral and 120 from line two to neutral. I saw nothing. There was zero voltage. So that first impression I had ended up being correct. There's voltages somewhere in this equipment. It's not passing through. So when you go, okay, inverter, no voltage, what's next? Next is your AC disconnect. Let's talk about AC disconnects for a little bit. So you're going to see one across country on almost every single residential solar system. It's the main disconnecting means, a way for the utility to isolate from the solar system, to isolate the solar system from the utility. It's a lever, like switchblade disconnect. This is a 60 amp GE fusible disconnect. They come in non-fusible types too, where there's no fuse holders. They essentially just have lugs on either side. And in just talking terminology here, you have what's called a line side and a load side, right? In this situation, our line side, this AC disconnect is the top. Our load side is the bottom, right? When you see a fusible disconnect in the solar space, that generally means that the interconnection method is a line side tap. What does a line side tap mean? A line side tap or supply side tap. What that is the point of interconnection is between the main breaker of that main service panel and the utility meter, right? There's conductors that go from the load side of the main revenue meter, that the customer's meter that every single house has, to the main breaker in that panel. And you can interconnect on those conductors. There's different methods to do that, whether it's Polaris blocks or ILSCO taps. We're not going to get into that right now, but understanding what it is, you're basically tapping ahead of the main breaker. So when you see a fusible disconnect and those taps are installed properly, you will always have voltage on the line side of your AC disconnect. So from a safety perspective, be aware of that. Understand that you see fuses, even with this lever off this top side, it's still going to be hot. Okay. Now you do want to check that it is hot, right? That's one of the first things that I did here after checking in the inverter. And okay, well, let's see if that voltage is present on my line side of my AC disconnect. So you take your voltmeter, you go line one, line two, there should be around 240. There was in this case, line one to neutral, line two to neutral, around 120. All checks out. Now, how do you see if there is voltage flowing through these fuses and to the load side of your AC disconnect? Now you have to turn this on. Remember this, when this is off like this, you're cutting off the voltage and the current from the load side. Understanding that, hey, I'm safe. You have your proper PPE. You have insulated tools. You have your gloves on. You have everything that you need to do this safely. You're going to turn that lever on. And you're going to test the same way you did up here at the top on your load side. Okay. You should see, if the fuses are not blown, you should see the same readings that you saw up here, down here, line one to line two. In this case, it was not present. My 240 was not there. When I went line one to neutral, 120 was there. Line two to neutral, no 120. So what does that tell us? That says, okay, the fuse on line one is good. It's okay. The fuse on line two is not good. It's likely blown. The next step is going to be to actually verify that this fuse is blown.